We want to solve each quadratic equation by factoring. Our first equation, we have x squared minus 9 equals 0. Here we need to recognize that x squared is a perfect square because it's equal to x times x. 9 is a perfect square because it's equal to 3 times 3, and we have a difference. So we have a difference of squares. And if it's helpful, we can write this as x squared minus 3 squared equals 0. And in this form, we can apply the difference of square formula. We're going to have one factor of x plus 3 and one factor of x minus 3. And now if this product is equal to 0, then either x plus 3 equals 0 or x minus 3 equals 0. So here if we subtract 3 on both sides, we have x equals negative 3. Or here we'd add 3 to both sides, so we'd have x equals positive 3. Now I should mention that sometimes you'll see these solutions written as x equals plus or minus 3. This is a short way to represent both solutions of positive 3 and negative 3. Looking at the second example, we should notice the first term's a perfect square because 9x times 9x is equal to 81x squared. The second term is a perfect square because 8 times 8 is equal to 64. And we have a difference, which means this will factor into two binomial factors. And if it's helpful, we can write this as 9x squared minus 8 squared equals 0. So this will factor into two binomial factors, where one factor will be 9x plus 8, and the other factor will be 9x minus 8. Which means this product will equal 0 only when 9x plus 8 equals 0, or when 9x minus 8 is equal to 0. So here we would subtract 8 on both sides, divide by 9. So we have x equals negative 8 ninths, or here we'll add 8 on both sides, divide by 9. So we have x equals positive 8 ninths, which again could be written as x equals plus or minus 8 ninths. And then again for the last example, we have another difference of squares because 25 is a perfect square, 4x squared is a perfect square, and we have a difference. And since 5 times 5 is equal to 25, and 2x times 2x is equal to 4x squared, one factor would be 5 plus 2x, and one factor would be 5 minus 2x. So this product will be 0 when 5 plus 2x equals 0, or when 5 minus 2x equals 0. So here we would subtract 5 on both sides, divide by 2. So we have x equals negative 5 halves, or here we would subtract 5 on both sides, and then divide by negative 2. So here we have x equals positive 5 halves. Or if we want, we can say x equals plus or minus 5 halves. Okay, I hope this helps.